औज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। आई एम नज़ीर अहमद वानी, मास्टर हाई स्कूल गुंडची बुद्रा। टुडे आई एम डिलीवरिंग लेसन फॉर क्लास 10th, सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी। माय टॉपिक इज सेक्चुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स और एंजियोस्पर्म्स, पार्ट 1। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज sexual reproduction? The reproduction which involves fusion of male and female gametes to form a new individual is called sexual reproduction. Second, we have to know what are the advantages of sexual reproduction over asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction leads to a greater variety in population. It promotes diversity of characters in offspring. It plays an important role in origin of new species. Then we come to sexual reproduction in flowering plants or angiosperms. The sex organs of a flowering plant are present in its flowers. Majority of plants are bisexual, that is, they bear both sexes, male and female, on them. The function of a flower is to make male and female gametes and to ensure that fertilization will take place to make new seeds for reproduction of a plant. Here I have drawn a diagram of a flower. Flower is the reproductive part of a plant. Here, this is the diagram of a flower. A flower has two types of structures. One is vegetative part and another is reproductive part. Here you see this is pedicel, that is the stalk of the flower. The uppermost part of this pedicel is called thalamus. It is enlarged. The thallium on the thalamus of pedicel exist four parts or four types of structures, that is sepals, petals, stamens and carpels. We see that a flower consists of four parts which I have mentioned. Sepals are green and vegetative, while as petals are brightly colored and they are also vegetative. Stamens are made of two parts, filament and anther. Anther contains pollen grains. This is the male part of a flower. Then fourth is carpel. Carpel is made of ovary, style and stigma. Ovary bears ovules which become seeds later on. Carpel is the female reproductive part of a flower. Here I have shown in the diagram, this is pedicel and bearing the upper part of this pedicel is here thalamus. Then these are green parts, sepals. The collective name of sepals is calyx. Then comes this bright colored leaves of flower, they are called petals. Collectively petals are known as corolla. Then these two parts are vegetative parts. Then comes the reproductive parts. First reproductive part is stamen. These are stamens are collectively known as androecium. They consist of two parts, each stamen. One part, the stalk of the filament is known as filament, and on the top of this filament, it bears anther and which contains pollen grains, which are the male reproductive cells, all male reproductive gametes. Then we have fourth part of flower, that is this carpel. Carpel consists of three parts, ovary, style and stigma. The ovary contains ovules which later on change, convert into seeds. This is the first part of sexual reproduction in flowering plants. I hope that you have got this. Next time I will discuss the second part of this topic.